Dear friends, today I speak to you as a father and a husband because it's Father's Day this Sunday. Father's Day is a very special day, and unfortunately, this Sunday, once again on Father's Day, many children will not have their father to say Happy Father's Day. And many fathers will possibly not have their children saying that to them because they are not with their family. It's very sad. I've traveled the length and breadth of my beautiful country, Australia. And I've met so many children, so many adults, people even at 70, who have wept while they spoke about their father who they never knew. For various reasons. Many children have approached me and said, we never knew what it was to get a hug from my father. I traveled to Canada, the States, Asia, Europe, and met many people who have not had a father in their lives. And it's created a major vacuum in their hearts. My father passed away in 1991. I wish I had more time to spend with him. There are times that I think of my dad and I feel really sad because I didn't really have the time to spend with him, to talk to him and ask him questions. In the last 3 months of his life, I got close to him. But sometimes you can look back and regret what's happened. What's happened, you can't undo it. But what can happen for the future, we can make it happen. So I just want to bring this message to every child, every family, every father. This Father's Day, make an effort to approach your dad. Every dad, make an approach to approach your children. I know some of you cannot approach your families because of restrictions by the court. But do your best in any way possible to communicate to your children that you love them. There are a lot of children looking for love. There are a lot of people in Australia who are looking for love. In fact, there are a lot of people who get into various trouble, like into drugs, alcohol, get into prison, and fatherlessness has been one of the key issues for children getting into such trouble. A father lacking in the house is a big vacuum. This Father's Day, you can make a difference. My son, who's 28, and his wife, they leave to Europe this week for 5 weeks. So since they would not be here on Father's Day, along with my other children, they took me out for dinner yesterday. And my son gave me this card. May I read it to you? We love you, Dad. And we pray that you have a wonderful Father's Day. I pray that God will continue to bless you and grow you from strength to strength, and that we will fulfill everything you plan for. You are a very great father, and one that have meant so much to me, from whom I have learnt a lot. As always, for everything you have done, thank you. This really touched my heart. Because what you sow is what you reap. I know there are circumstances which have come through life which cause people to be separate. But why don't we make a change? Why don't we do something different this Father's Day? Why don't we extend a hand of love to somebody? Why don't we do something really, really encouraging, really supportive, really doing something good? Because there are too many people who are heartbroken. There are too many people who are hurting. There are too many people who are angry. There are too many people who are carrying a lot of offense. Let's reach out with love. Let's take this message across to our nation and the nations. This Father's Day, love your father. You might say, but he's not been there for me. I understand, I agree. But the more we carry offense, the more it hurts us. The more does it make us angry. Why don't we forgive? Why don't we forget? I can talk of someone who did an amazing thing. Our Heavenly Father in heaven gave it all so that we could be connected back into His presence. So let the Father on earth be our role model. Reach out to Him this Father's Day and be blessed. Happy Father's Day to every dad out there. God bless you.